withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you, withholding nothing. Withholding nothing.
Come on, you say.
Everything I give to you, oh God.
Welcome to the three. If you would grab us three little words, and if so, okay. Psalms, the book of Psalms, Psalm 7, verse 1, 2, and 3. If you have it in your Bible, say amen.
Amen.
Okay. King James Version. Let's begin at verse 1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the redeemer of the Lord say so, whom he had redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and gathered them out of the land, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south. And the church said,
amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we want to thank you for what you have done for us and how you brought us from so many different things. And Lord, we give your name the praise, the glory, and the honor. This we ask in your Son, Jesus' name. Our soul said, amen. Look at your name, your neighbor.
Amen.
It was because of God's amazing grace. Come on,
it was because
of God's amazing grace.
You may
be seated. Amen. It was because of God's amazing grace. And the things that we come out of, God brings us up out of. It's not because we were so smart and so intelligent that we can get ourselves out of the trouble that we have gotten ourselves into. We can heal ourselves, we can deliver ourselves. Amen. But it's because of God's amazing grace. Amen. That we wasn't destroyed and wherever and whatever we were in. But he brought us out. And the psalmist is writing here this 107th psalm that's letting us know. It says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Yeah.
And I am one of the ones that's redeemed, have been redeemed.
Yeah.
And I have whom he had redeemed out of the hands of the enemy. And the enemy had his hands on me in life, but God had redeemed me from his hand.
Yeah.
That was a good place. Been in trouble, but God, you tell God, amen. I've been redeemed.
Amen.
I have been redeemed. Amen. And this particular psalm that's written here not only talks to us about God redeeming us, but it goes along with the lyrics that a songwriter, John Chris Newton, he wrote a song. I penned the song, we got the lyrics from his song, Amazing Grace. I don't know if he was the author of it or not, but he wrote it or rewrote it for one of the two. And in that particular song, Amazing Grace said, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound, save a wretch like me. See, I once was lost, and now I'm found.
Yes.
Was blind, but now I'm free, now I see. And it's amazing how God, when he just delivers us from something,
yes.
When we can't seem to find our way out. Amen. I don't know. Maybe I'm the only one that's been tangled up in a spider web before. And get it all over your face. And all. You never walk into a spider web and get that stuff all over you.
Yes.
Seem like, I mean, it's nasty. Somebody help me. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
I mean, it's nasty. Just, you know, I just may be the only one, but since this is October, you see a lot of spider web around. I thought, you know, folks get all tangled up. Imagine, I want you to understand that It's God's grace that's going to be able to untangle us from the web that the enemy has.
Amen.
The snares that he's trapped, that he's set before us, it's going to be God's grace that's going to keep us out of those traps.
Amen.
It's going to keep us if we get caught by the trap. Somebody help me here.
Wow.
Amen. It's God's grace. And here in this particular song, Amazing Grace, not verse 1, but verse 2, it said, through many dangerous toils and snares, I've already come. It says, "'Tis grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me on." I had to write that down because I couldn't remember those tears and tugs. Tears, grace, I couldn't remember all of them. And so I wrote the lyrics down so I could repeat it so that you could understand that we've gone through many dangerous toils. We've gone through some things in our life that's really dangerous.
Yeah.
I mean, I consider them dangerous. Amen. And I'd be the first to tell you that I'm going to give God some praise and glory in it. Amen. If you take the time and just think about your life. Amen. Look at your neighbor, think about your Bible. And you need to just reminisce of your historical pilgrimage that you have taken so far. Whatever your age is, you ought to think about what God has brought you from. Just a little bit of things, a glimpse of things that you have experienced in life that could have taken you out. Just a little. Sometimes you're in a car and then all of a sudden the car skid. And we just take that as just the car skid, but it's a little more than just the car skid. Because some cars that skidded right off the road. And there was no survival. Took a trip up in the mountain? Have you ever rode a mountain road and you looked over the cliff? Some cars that went up that road just went all over the cliff. But God's grace has kept us. If it wasn't for the grace of God, we would have been wiped out. So when we remember it, we go back and we think about our historical journey and our journey. My mind takes me back to Israel and how Israel had to remind themselves of their historical journey. They had to remind themselves of their pilgrimage that they had taken. And when you go back to Abraham, how God called Abraham, the father of faith, called him from nowhere into somewhere, told him, I want you to leave your father and mother's house, and I want you to go to a land that I'm going to show you. It took faith to do that. Amen. It took faith to trust God, to believe that God was going to be there every step of the way. Yes, it does. Sometimes we think that we can do things on our own power, but if you think you can do it on your own power, every now and then you're going to find out your power will let you down. But God's grace ain't going to be there. It's going to hold you up and sustain you. Well, Abraham, in the journey that the children of Israel took in the journey from Abraham to the promised land. God promised Abraham that he's going to give him a land that's full of milk and honey, which comprised, it was the promised land. And Israel had to walk this journey out. And they had to walk this journey out from Abraham on. And we find it as we go through the scripture that they kept on walking and they kept on believing God. They kept getting in trouble, but they kept walking and they kept believing God. Sometimes in your walk with God, you might get in trouble. Tell your neighbor, I know that's right. Tell them again, because they don't believe you. Amen. Yes, you are. Amen. The devil will see to it that you get in trouble. Amen. If you don't think you're in trouble, the devil will make sure that you get in trouble. Amen. He'll try to take and get you to give up and throw in the towel. Amen. Forget about the God that brought you out. Forget about the God that delivered you. But I began to look at this psalmist and look at Israel and look at their walk. Amen. And it gets me to understand, hey, yeah, it is. It was because of the grace of God. When I look back over my life where God had brought me from, it was because it was amazing grace. It was amazing. My life, it was amazing. Somebody help me here. Sometimes you can't appreciate somebody else's life, amen, because you don't appreciate your life,
amen.
You don't appreciate what God brought you from. But if you think about what God brought you from and think about what the horrors that he brought you out of, you can really give him some praise. God amen, for God, the children of Israel, amen, they had to think about what God had done for them, and think about the things that he did, and how when they got themselves in trouble, they found themselves from Abraham on into Moses, and found themselves down in Egypt, and how the children of Israel, when they were down in Egypt, that how it was miraculously how God orchestrated for them to get into Egypt. See, it wasn't so that they were supposed to just go there. They were just walking there. It was a trick that they did with their brother. Come on. They tell me that they hear that their brother was put in a pit. Uh-huh. And they put his brother in a pit, Joseph. And when Joseph was in the pit, these are the same children of Israel. When Joseph was in the pit, they tell me that his brothers conspired to say that Joseph was dead. But the oldest brother said, no, we can't do that. They said, no, we can't tell Dad that he was dead right now. We can't kill our brother. We got to do something else with him. So they conspired. They said, well, let's play like he was dead. Let's take his coat and let's put some blood on it. And let's take it back to Dad and tell him some animal tore him apart. But at the meantime, when the brother got away, Reuben, the oldest brother, sometimes when the one that got, who got good sense, and that don't have good sense, don't act like they got good sense. Oh, I'm talking that. I'm preaching. I'm going to preach to the choir. Let me talk to this side. Sometimes, you know, the oldest ones sometimes act like they don't have good sense. If they who has stepped aside, while he stepped aside, the younger ones took action. Sometimes young people take action and they'll take it too fast. But it might be things the wrong way, but it ended up turning out working for the good. Was coming, going down to Egypt. They sold their brother into slavery. Tell me that Joseph found himself down in Egypt, being a slave with the Ishmaelites. But everywhere that Joseph went, he found himself in charge. Found himself in the pit. God delivered him, brought him up out of the pit. I'm telling you, when you begin to start thinking about journeys and the different ones, you can't do nothing else but say, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. I'm trying to see this thing, trying to talk it real fast, but let me break it down for a second. Listen here. If you go back to Psalms 105 says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. When you go back into the same psalm, let's go to the next chapter. Psalms 106 says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. When you drop in this chapter where we are right now, to Psalms 107, it says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord. It lets us know about the triune God. Talks about how each time you see where God, each one of these chapters are giving us a picture of what we ought to do for God, no matter what we go through with. Each one of these chapters gives us something different. One of the chapters that when we're giving thanks unto God, it talks about Israel, history. Just like I said, Psalms 105 talks about the history of Israel. In Psalms 106, their history turned into misery. And when they were in a miserable state, God took that miserable state and they learned how to give God praise in that misery. And then when eyes were set for the promised land, you find that in the promised land that God promised them that I'm going to give you, I'm going to bless you. Abraham, I'm going to bless you. You find if you follow Israel history, after all they went through with, God finally blessed them. Let me tell you something, no matter what you're going through, if God says you're going to have it, it's going to happen. If God said it's going to happen, it's going to happen. Come on, somebody. If God said I'm going to bless you, he's going to bless you. If you got to go through with something in order to get your blessing, go ahead on through with it. Don't complain, don't murmur, go ahead on through with it. Instead of murmuring and complaining, just give God some thanks. Just bless God. Well, as you began to look at this text here, it began to share unto us. It said, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endure forever. You know, if we talk about God's grace, we can't talk about his grace without his mercy. Because his mercy is what stopped us from getting cut off. If it hadn't been for the mercy of God, wow. It wasn't for God's mercy. Somebody help me here. wrestling match and then they was in the arena. I haven't been a wrestler, but I used to watch wrestling. I used to watch wrestling back in the time when Bruno Sammartino was a wrestler. Amen. Whoa.
Wow.
Who? Bruno Sammartino, he was a wrestler. I wish I had somebody on what I'm talking about. Before the trap snapped the finger. That now, don't you think the mice are the only people that get, try to get that, try to do that? I'm convinced kids do that too. I'm convinced it snapped that finger real good.
Yes.
Okay, all right, let's do it another way. You're at work somewhere. Now, y'all feel that? Okay, you're at work and you got a mousetrap that you got set. And it's the old fashioned kind that you got to put something on it. You got the little spring and the little wire. You got to hook that wire up. That's over here in my hand.
Oh, Lord.
I'm talking about Israel, the children of Israel.
Yes.
There were traps set for them.
Yes.
That the enemy had set and put bait on. And they felt as though they could take the bait off and not get hit with the trap.
Mom.
You can't fool around with the devil and think you're not going to get in. You can't be, you know, a strong Christian at church and a hypocrite at, somebody help me here. Israel was in a state after they reflected their past and they realized that their past got them in trouble. They were at a state in chapter 106. When you go back and you read Psalm 106, they had stuff that was coming against them constantly. And it was coming against them because of the past. And sometimes in our foolishness, it'll cause us to cry out unto God. And after a while, we get ourselves together. Somebody say, after a while.
After a while.
Mm-hmm. After a while, I'm going to get myself together and I'm going to go on into my promised land. We ought to be able to walk in our blessings, amen, while we're able to enjoy them.
Amen.
I don't shouldn't get old and can't enjoy what God has blessed me with. I want to enjoy what I have while I can enjoy it. It was a blessing. It was because of God's amazing grace that He didn't cut us off.
Amen.
He could have killed us and caused us not to go any further, but He allowed us not to enjoy His blessing. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Let the redeemer of the Lord say so. Stand to your feet, all of us.
Withholding nothing, I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you.